लेसन नंबर 8, डिफीट ऑफ इंटरनल एनिमीज बाय यूज ऑफ फोर्स। द मावलास ऑफ द 12 मावल्स गैदर्ड राउंड शिवाजी रेडी टू डू इज बिडिंग। दे लिव्ड फॉर स्वराज एंड वर विलिंग टू डाई फॉर इट। दे वर सिंपल मराठा फोक। They loved Shivaji more than their life, but some people were jealous of Shivaji's achievements. He had to bring such people to book. Kandoji and Baji Gurpade were two sardars in the service of Adil Shah. The Shah incited them against Shivaji. They created a lot of trouble in the Kundana district, but Shivaji was more than a match for them. He defeated and drew them out. Bajaji Naik Nimbalkar of Paltan was Shivaji's own brother-in-law, but Shivaji Maharaj had to fight many battles against him. However, later on, members of this family stood by Shivaji Maharaj. Sambhaji Mohite of Supe, a near relative of Shivaji, also started plotting against Shivaji. Shivaji arrested him at Supe and banished him to Karnataka. With Shivaji, duty came first and relatives afterwards. Chandra Rao More of Chavli. The greatness of Shivaji's achievements was recognized and applauded everywhere. He captivated the heart of his people. Some people did not like this. They looked upon Shivaji as a mole in the eye. The More of Javli was one such person. More was the Jagirdar of Javli. This Jagir, which extended from Raigarh to Koyna Valley, along with the title Chandra Rao, was conferred upon him by Adil Shah. Javli was covered with such a thick forest that even during broad daylight, the sun's rays hardly penetrated it. It was full of wildlife. Tigers, wolves, and bears roamed freely in the Javli forest. More Javli was thus like a tiger's hideout. No one therefore crossed More's path. Only Shivaji had the courage to do so. Daulat Rao More died in 1645. There was fight for the succession among his descendants. Shivaji backed Yashwant Rao More, who with Shivaji's help ascended the Gadi as Chandra Rao. In return for Shivaji's help, Yashwant Rao promised to help Shivaji in his struggle and also pay him an annual tribute. But he forgot all this once he succeeded to the Gadi. He became impertinent and troublesome. He started attacking Shivaji's territory and arresting the people. Shivaji realized that unless More was punished, he would remain a constant danger to Swaraj. Rebel and you will die. Shivaji first sent a stiff note to Yashwantrao More. You call yourself the Raja, but I am the Raja of this territory. This kingdom is Lord Shiva's gift to me, so do not call yourself the Raja. In a very rude reply, Yashwantrao said, you are a Raja of only yesterday. Who gave you this kingdom? If you come to Javali, you will be trapped. By the grace of God, I have received from Adil Shah the title of Raja. He has also, in his graciousness, given me a throne and the panoply of a Raja. If you start any trouble here, you will be badly hurt. Shivaji replied, give up Javali and your pretensions to kingship. Come before your master with folded hands and accept his service. You will refuse to do so at the risk of your life. The conquest of Javali was a difficult operation. It was covered with thick forest and protected by the impregnable Rairi fort. More also had numerous followers. Shivaji, after making thorough preparations, attacked Javali. Yashwantrao held out for about a month but suffered very heavy losses. He then escaped to Rairi along with his family. Shivaji conquered Javali and then marched on Rairi. He laid siege to Fort Rairi. Yashwantrao fought desperately for 3 months, but he had to give up. Fort Raigarh. The conquest of Javali was a very important landmark. This doubled the boundaries of Swaraj under Shivaji. Yashwantrao's army too joined the forces of Shivaji. The strong Rairi fort became a part of Swaraj. Shivaji was highly pleased to have this fort under his control. He changed its name to Raigarh. Later on, he built a new fort on the Borpia Hill nearby. It was named Pratapgarh.